Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Kisi-kisi materi kuliah umum Sabtu sore sepanjang masa. Electric Teleconference 21 Mei tahun 2030. 3 Masehi. Mission of materials of the public lecture of afternoon Saturday over time with Electric Teleconference of Man. May of Fresh of Year 2033 and not Domini. Arahan pendiri dan ketua umum Majelis Pimpinan Pusat Global Yayasan Mandiri Raya, the direction from the founder and the general chairman of the Central Global Leadership Assembly of the Great Mandailing Foundation, Agus Salim ST bin Abdurrahim Nasution. Materi-materi kuliah umum Sabtu sore sepanjang masa Electronic Teleconference di Kantor Pusat Global Majelis Pimpinan Pusat Global Yayasan Mandiri Raya. Materials of the public lecture of afternoon Saturday over time with Electric Teleconference in the Global Head Office of the Central Global Leadership Assembly of the Great Mandailing Foundation. Sabtu 21 Mei tahun 2033, materi kuliah umum e-teleconference, eksistensi koordinator Biro Pemenuhan Kebutuhan Sandang Rakyat, Divisi Program Pro-Rakyat, Majelis Pimpinan Rukun Tetangga Yayasan Mandiri Raya di seluruh dunia yang dikonsentrasi taktiskan di Kabupaten Mandiri Natal, yang terdapat dalam jurnal bulanan analisis riset mikron gen biologis sepanjang masa. Nomor 280 bulan April tahun 2033, Saturday 21st of Man May 2033, Public Lecture Material e-teleconference, existence of the coordinator of the Bureau of Accomplishment for People Clothing Needs, the Division of Program for People of the Neighborhood Leadership Assembly of the Great Mandailing Foundation. On what wide we concern and tactic in Kabupaten Mandiri Natal contained in the Mandi Journal of Disease Analysis of Biological Genetic Micron over time. Number 280 of Man April 2033, Koordinator Biro Pemenuhan Kebutuhan Sandang Rakyat, Divisi Program Pro Rakyat, Majelis Pimpinan Rukun Tetangga Yayasan Mandiri Raya, untuk merekomendasikan kepada jurusan Teknik Sipil, Fakultas Teknik Sipil dan Lingkungan, jurusan Hukum Administrasi Negara, jurusan Hukum Masyarakat dan Pembangunan, jurusan Hukum Bisnis, jurusan Hukum Ekonomi, jurusan Hukum Perdagangan Internasional, dan jurusan Hukum Keuangan Negara, Fakultas Hukum, jurusan Pendidikan Teknik dan Kejuruan, jurusan Pendidikan Ekonomi dan jurusan Pendidikan Teknik Bangunan, Fakultas Keguruan dan Ilmu Pendidikan, Manajemen dan Kebijakan Publik, Ilmu Administrasi Negara dan Ilmu Administrasi Publik, Fakultas Ilmu Sosial dan Ilmu Politik, Muamalah Hukum Bisnis Islam, Keuangan Islam dan Hukum Ekonomi Syariah, Fakultas Syariah, jurusan Teknik Sipil dan Lingkungan, Fakultas Teknologi Pertanian, jurusan Ekonomi dan Studi Pembangunan dan jurusan Ekonomi Sumber Daya dan Lingkungan, Fakultas Ekonomi dan Manajemen, jurusan Perencanaan dan Kebijakan Publik, dan jurusan Bisnis Islam. Fakultas Ekonomi, the Department of Urban Studies and Planning, School of Architecture and Planning, Civil and Environmental Engineering, School of Engineering. Business Administration Program Agusalim Management, Jurusan Perencanaan Wilayah dan Kota, Sekolah Arsitektur Perencanaan dan Pengembangan Kebijakan, dan Jurusan Manajemen dan Jurusan Kewirausahaan, Sekolah Bisnis dan Manajemen Universitas Mandailing, untuk memutairkan dengan memahami Surat Edaran Nomor 10 SEM 2018 tentang pemberlakuan standar dokumen pemilihan pengadaan jasa konstruksi dalam rangka lelang dini di Kementerian Pekerjaan Umum dan Perumahan Rakyat. Untuk tahun anggaran 2019, yaitu lampiran 3 surat edaran Menteri Pekerjaan Umum dan Perumahan Rakyat nomor 10 SEM 2018 tentang pemberlakuan standar dokumen pemilihan pengadaan jasa konstruksi dalam rangka lelang dini di Kementerian Pekerjaan Umum dan Perumahan Rakyat untuk tahun anggaran 2019, yaitu The Coordinator of the Bureau of Accomplishment for People Clothing Needs, the Division of Program for People of the Naval Leadership Assembly of the Great Mandailing Foundation, to recommend to the Department of Civil Engineering, the Faculty of Civil and Environmental Engineering, the Department of State Administrative Law, the Department of Law of Public and Development, the Department of Business Law, the Department of Economic Law, the Department of International Trade Law, and the Department of State Financial Law, the Faculty of Law, the Department of Engineering and Vocational Education, the Department of Economics Education, and the Department of Building Engineering Education. The Faculty of Teacher Training and Education Science, Management and Public Policy, State Administration Science and Public Administration Science, the Faculty of Social Sciences and Political Sciences, Mu'amalah, Islamic Business Law, Islamic Finance and Sharia Economic Law, the Faculty of Sharia, the Department of Civil and Environmental Engineering, the Faculty of Agricultural Technology, the Department of Economics and Development Studies, and the Department of Resource and Environmental Economics, the Faculty of Economics and Management, the Department of Planning and Public Policy, and the Department of Islamic Business, the Faculty of Economics, the Department of Urban Studies and Planning School, of Architecture and Planning, Civil and Environmental Engineering, School of Engineering, Business Administration Program, Agusalim Management. The Department of Regional and City Planning, the School of Architecture, Planning and Policy Development, and the Department of Management, and the Department of Entrepreneurship, the School of Business and Management of Mandailing University, to update by understanding the circular letter number 10 SEM 2018 concerning enforcement of standard of selection documents for the procurement of construction services in the context of election in the Ministry of Public Works and Public Housing for budget year 2019, namely is Annex 3 of the Circular Letter number 10 SEM 2018 concerning enforcement of standard of selection documents for the procurement of construction services in the context of early auction in the Ministry of Public Works and Public Housing for budget year 2019, namely syarat-syarat umum kontrak, general terms of contract. Syarat-syarat umum kontrak, general terms of contract. Tenaga kerja konstruksi dan atau peralatan penyedia, labor construction and or for further equipment. Tenaga kerja konstruksi, construction workers. Setiap tenaga kerja konstruksi yang bekerja pada pekerjaan ini wajib memiliki sertifikat kompetensi kerja. Every construction worker who work for this job must have a work competency certificate. Tenaga kerja konstruksi selain personel manajerial yang bekerja akan bekerja pada pekerjaan ini dan belum memiliki sertifikat kompetensi kerja, maka penyedia wajib memastikan dipenuhinya persyaratan sertifikat kompetensi kerja sepanjang masa pelaksanaan. Construction worker other than managerial personnel who work will work in this job and do not have a work competency certificate. The forefather must ensure that the work competency certificate is fulfilled throughout the implementation period. Personel manajerial dan atau peralatan utama, managerial personnel and or main equipment. Personel manajerial yang ditempatkan dan dipekerjakan harus sesuai dengan yang tercantum dalam lampiran A. Syarat-syarat khusus kontrak, managerial personnel placed and employed must comply with those listed in Appendix A of the contract specific conditions, peralatan utama yang ditempatkan dan digunakan untuk pelaksanaan. Pekerjaan adalah peralatan yang layak dan harus sesuai dengan yang tercantum dalam lampiran A syarat-syarat khusus kontrak. The main equipment placed and used for the execution of work is equipment that is visible and must be in accordance with those listed in Appendix A of the contract specific conditions. Penggantian personel manajerial dan atau peralatan utama tidak boleh dilakukan kecuali atas persetujuan tertulis dari pejabat pembuat komitmen dan dituangkan dalam adendum kontrak. Replacement of managerial personnel and or main equipment may not be carried out except with written approval from the commitment making officer and set forth in the contract addendum. Jika penggantian personel manajerial dan atau peralatan utama perlu dilakukan, maka penyedia berkewajiban untuk menyediakan pengganti dengan kualifikasi yang setara atau lebih baik dari tenaga kerja konstruksi dan atau peralatan yang digantikan tanpa biaya tambahan apapun. If the replacement of managerial personnel and or main equipment needs to be done, then the provider is obliged to provide substitutes with qualifications that are equal or better than the construction workforce and or equipment that is replaced without any additional cost. Pejabat pembuat komitmen dapat menyetujui penempatan penggantian personel manajerial dan atau peralatan utama menurut kualifikasi yang dibutuhkan setelah mendapat rekomendasi dari pengawas pekerjaan. The commitment making officer can approve the replacement of managerial personnel and or main equipment according to the qualification required after obtaining a recommendation from the work supervisor. Jika pejabat pembuat komitmen menilai bahwa personel manajerial tidak mampu atau tidak dapat melakukan pekerjaan dengan baik, berkelakuan tidak baik, dan atau mengabaikan pekerjaan yang menjadi tugasnya, maka penyedia berkewajiban untuk menyediakan pengganti dan menjamin personel manajerial tersebut meninggalkan lokasi kerja dalam waktu 7 hari kalender sejak diminta oleh pejabat pembuat komitmen. If the commitment making officer assesses that managerial personnel unable to do a good job, bad behavior and or ignore the work that is his duty, then the provider is obliged to provide a replacement and ensure that the managerial personnel leave the work location within 7 calendar days from the time requested by the commitment making officer. Personel manajerial berkewajiban untuk menjaga kerahasiaan pekerjaannya jika diperlukan oleh pejabat pembuat komitmen. Personel manajerial dapat sewaktu-waktu disyaratkan untuk menjaga kerahasiaan pekerjaan di bawah sumpah. Managerial personnel are obliged to maintain the confidentiality of their work if required by the commitment making officer. Managerial personnel may be required at any time to maintain the confidentiality of work under oath. Apabila ada penambahan personel manajerial dan atau peralatan utama, maka penambahan tersebut harus mendapat persetujuan terlebih dahulu dari pejabat pembuat komitmen dan dituangkan dalam lampiran A syarat-syarat khusus kontrak. If there are additional of managerial personnel and or main equipment, the addition must be approved in advance by the commitment making officer. and set forth in Appendix A of the contract specific terms. Sumber-sumber sursis Surat Edaran Nomor 10 SEM 2018 tentang pemberlakuan standar dokumen pemilihan. Pengadaan jasa konstruksi dalam rangka lelang dini di Kementerian Pekerjaan Umum dan Perumahan Rakyat untuk tahun anggaran 2019, lampiran 3. Circular letter number 10 SEM 2018 concerning enforcement of the selection document standard for procurement of construction service in the context of election in the Minister of Public Works and Public Housing for budget year 2019 and next year, Google Translate. Mandailing Natal, Sumatera Utara, Indonesia, 1 Mei tahun 2033 Masehi, Feast of Man May 2023 and Anno Domini. Thank you very much.